And welcome to another edition of the Rams Legends pregame show. I'm Pep Fernandez. Of course, everybody knows this guy, the legendary Greg Bell.
Well, I was hoping that you won't be a legendary.
Well, Greg, we're moments away from kickoff here at the historic L.A. Coliseum as the Rams are set for their second preseason game against the Kansas City Chiefs. Let's rewind to their first preseason game. What did you like? Maybe what did you not like that you want to see the Rams improve upon for the Chiefs today?
I will. The first thing they have to improve on is just overall tackling. I think when we talked about it during the training camp, one of the things that's really, for me, missing is that actual hitting, repetition, tackling, wrapping up. And we saw with the first play of the game last week in the game against the Dallas Cowboys, a 99 kickoff return isn't what we want to see the season start off with. Just good, proper defensive tackle.
So we saw the Rams put together an incredible second half comeback. They pulled out the win in a game that saw the Rams return to Los Angeles, the first one here. That was great. But moving forward now, what do they have to do to not fall behind early? They wanted the number ones, the starters,
right,
got to give them a lead, right?
And I think that's really the biggest basis of last week. We didn't see a lot of the starters. You didn't see Todd Gurley at all. Saw very limited play in Jared Goff. So what we're going to look for this week is those number one crews that play are probably about a quarter and a half. It won't be till next week till you see them go past the halftime. So I think if anything that you're going to look for this week is just looking for overall continuity and these guys playing as one, you know, a number one unit, number two unit.
So when you look at the preseason as a whole, that game three is kind of the make or break game, isn't it? Like when you put your starters in there and see what they can do and then you hold them back for game four. I mean, how do you kind of budget that four-game preseason schedule?
I think a lot of people look at preseason as an opportunity to see where that team is going. Most of these coaches know where the team is going to be at. They're still evaluating backup roles right now. They know who their number ones are. They've got to find the role players. And it's going to take a full preseason to see who those role players are because, believe it or not, there are a lot of nicks in practice. There are a lot of pull strains. So you don't see everybody every single week. So what they're going to be doing over the next 3 weeks is truly evaluating their ones, their twos, threes, and some of these utility players that they're going to have to use.
That's a great point. Maybe more importantly, right? The twos and the threes, the guys who are right there on the bubble, right?
Right. And really, that's what preseason is for more than anything. When I played in this game, it was about getting yourself conditioned and ready to play. These guys are year-round training. They're ready to play. It's about finding out who the players are that you're going to have that's going to play the game.
All right, for Greg Bell and Pep Fernandez, we'll see you next time on the Rams Legends pregame show.